Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is Ashima and in this video, we'll be talking about daily news events or daily current affairs. Now, the discussion is going to involve a lot of topics which we are going to talk about in details so that it is helpful for all the examination aspirants, right? So the purpose of the video is to help you attain an insight towards the news event as well as gain the important points which are important for your examination or interview or your descriptive examination. That is to gain a perspective of the news event. So you can easily share the video to anyone you feel will be benefited. Anyone who is preparing for examination will gain benefits from this video, right? And second of all, do subscribe to the channel for daily updates. Third of all, for all those who want the questions also and want daily content and practice sets and mocks or content videos, for that purpose, we have Entry app which you can download from Google Play Store. And once you download the app, you do the initial registration process, you get access to the free live quiz that happens on the app. Also, you'll get a lot of videos and a lot of courses which are available there. So do download the app and check that out. Right. Now we'll be beginning with our discussion. The first news event which we are going to talk about is privatization of public sector banks, government to bring two amendments. Now we have already seen that during the budgetary presentation or during the budget presentation, the finance minister of India had clearly specified something about privatization of public sector banks to take place, in which it was specified that IDBI and two more public sector banks are going to be privatized. The names have not yet been finalized. But when a privatization is supposed to take place, then there was certain time when there was a time when there was nationalization of banks, right? So the government needs to change those acts which were there for nationalization of banks so that the privatization can be done. And for that part, we have two acts, that is Banking Companies Acquisition and Transfer of Undertakings Act 1970 and Banking Companies Acquisition and Transfer of Undertakings Act 1980. Both of these acts were there which enhanced the privatization of banks, for nationalization of banks. And now these two acts need to be amended so that privatization can take place. Now, is this the first time that the government is doing privatization? No, privatization of public sector banks has been done earlier also. But why is it being done? First question. Although we have made a separate video altogether on the same channel for privatization of banks, where you will understand the perspective. But over here, the target of government is to generate 1.75 lakh crores via disinvestment drive. And that disinvestment is being done in the banking sector as well. Now, where all have we seen the merger taking place? So there were 27 public sector banks initially, and now they have been reduced to 12 public sector banks. So how has this happened? What was the process? So the most recent one is the time when 10 public sector banks were merged into 4 public sector banks, as you can see over here. PNB, OBC and Union, United Bank of India were merged to PNB. Then Canara Bank and Syndicate Bank were merged to Canara Bank. UBI, Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank were merged to Union Bank. And Indian Bank and Allahabad Bank were merged to Indian Bank. So with this, these 10 public sector banks were merged into 4 public sector banks. Then before this in 2019, we had witnessed when Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank. Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank. Both of them were merged with Bank of Baroda, and therefore three banks had become one bank, right? And before that, SBI and its associate banks like State Bank of Patiala, State Bank of Hyderabad, State Bank of Mysore, State Bank of Bikaner and Jaipur, State Bank of Travancore and Bharatiya Mahila Bank. So SBI, its associates, associate banks, as I told you, I just listed them, and Mahila Bank. All three were merged into State Bank of India. So over here, there were approximately 7 banks which are merged into one. So with all of that, we can see that from 27, we moved to 12, and we'll be reducing the number further, Right. Now, going ahead to the next news event, that is a credit default swap. Now, this has been revealed by Reserve Bank of India recently. We all know that Financial Literacy Week is going on, and in the duration, the theme of Financial Literacy Week is related to credits and giving more and more, or imparting more and more information about how credit score helps. Now, RBI has revealed a credit default swap, which will allow the retail users to do the transactions in permitted credit derivatives in order to hedge their underlying credit risk. Now, so what happens is, all that credit risk that is there, that credit risk can be managed via credit swap. Now, what exactly is a financial swap or a credit swap? It is basically a contract. First, we'll be learning about that. So, a contract or a derivative that permits the investor to swap or offset his credit risk with another investor. In this way, the credit score can be improved of the investor for a whole. Right now, financial swap agreement is the one. It's a kind of financial swap agreement. So, this like something that you give and take, something like that, a swap happens. So the seller of this credit swap or credit default swap will compensate the buyer in case of a debit default, in that case of a debt default. Right now, what happens is the buyer of CDS will make a series of payments to seller and will expect to receive the payoff in case of an asset default. And in case an asset default is there, then the buyer of CDS will receive the compensation while the seller of CDS will take the possession of the loan. Right? So this is how this whole credit swap works, and this has been unveiled for people of India, that is, who are residents of India or who are non-residents of India or NRIs. Both of them can avail the facility via this. Right? Now, further, ECO Pact is there. Now, what is ECO Pact? It is a new low carbon range of concrete that has been unveiled recently by ACC Ready Mix Concrete. Now, this is launched in Mumbai and Hyderabad for the first phase, but soon enough it is going to be launched all over India. And this is a kind of a cement which helps in reducing the carbon dioxide emissions or CO2 emissions. And up to what range? CO2 emissions are reduced to a range of 100% in this. The reduction will be up to 100%, and it is very helpful for those buildings which have a curvature or circular buildings, right? And how come this is reducing carbon dioxide emissions is because it has reduced the carbon dioxide binders for that purpose. Right. All right. Now, ACC Limited, if we talk about, which has launched this new carbon range of concrete, it is a subsidiary of Lafarge Holcim. Right. Then going with the PIMO e-bike. Now, PIMO e-bike has been launched by PI Beam. And PI Beam, if we talk about, is basically a IIT Madras startup. So PI Beam is an IIT Madras startup, and it has launched this two-wheeler by the name PIMO that you can see over here. This is a kind of an electronic vehicle bicycle or two-wheeler bicycle, which is electronic in format, and it has been founded by IIT Madras alum Vishak Shashikumar. Right now, that in financial year 2021-22, they are aiming that by the end of this year, about 10,000 vehicles are going to be sold. And what is so special about it? First of all, it can easily charge faster than a smartphone. Second of all, its range is 50 kilometers. That is, once it is completely charged, it can run for 50 kilometers. So its range is 50 kilometers. Third of all, it can be used for personal also, for commercial purpose also. Fourth of all, the price of this is at 30,000 rupees. And neither does it require a license, nor does it require a registration. Right? Then, furthermore, what else is there in this? If we talk about the speed of this bike has its top speed of 25 kmph. So its top speed, the maximum speed that it can reach is 25 kmph. All right. Then going ahead to a few one-liners. Now, what are the one-liners? First of all, third edition of Indian Sign Language Dictionary is going to be released. Now, this is a third edition that is going to be released. So, when were the earlier editions released? So, earlier, the first edition was released in 2018. Then the next edition was released in 2019. And now in 2021, we have the third edition coming up. This new edition is going to have about 10,000 terms, and it is going to have academic, legal, medical, technical, administrative, agriculture, all forms of terms in it, right? Earlier, the 2019 one dictionary had about 6,000 terms. The first edition had 3,000 terms. Now, why do we need this dictionary? This is something which is for hearing and speech impaired. So, to make them feel comfortable, and you know, to bring in the connectivity with them, to make them less discriminated towards, for that purpose this book is launched, right? So the purpose of this book is just to bring in a more of equality, as we can say. Then the lower house of French Parliament has approved anti-radicalism bill in a bid to fight the Islamic radicalism. Now, earlier this bill was proposed, and if you people remember, this bill was there, which was proposed in October 2020. And the bill's purpose was to strengthen the government oversight on mosques, on religious schools, and to bring in strong actions against, you know, forced marriages and polygamy, and bring in more respect towards the French values. And it is a part of a broader, aspect as to bringing in a surveillance towards it, right? To bring in lesser conflicts due to, as they say, due to Muslim, of the French Muslims, as we can say, and to bring in a more of surveillance towards their activities. Right. So this act was initially launched in October 2020, which has brought a lot of criticism at that time also. And now again, it is bringing a lot of criticism, but still it is going on. Right. Then the government of India has approved the production linked incentive scheme. Now, we all know PLI scheme has been ongoing, and PLI is an incentive based output generated scheme for which, you know, the more the profits are there, the more incentive is given by the government to certain sectors. Now, in that, telecom sector was added recently as per the recent recommendation, and approving of that recommendation, telecom sector has also approved it. Now, Niti Aayog had given a suggestion, and telecom sector has also approved that yes, PLI scheme can be implemented in telecom sector as well. This scheme was initially launched with mobile and electronics, and slowly and gradually the number of sectors have been increasing, with pharmacy also being one of the sectors which have been included in this. Then we have National Informatics Center, which has launched an app called Sandesh. Now, Sandesh was initially launched in August 2020, and at that time it was only for government officials. Right, so it was only for government officials. Then slowly and gradually it was extended to and from Android version, it was extended to iPhone version or iOS also, and now it has been open to public. And this is something that works just like you know, WhatsApp, and it's a messaging feature which via which registration can be done via email or via mobile number. And this is more of like a communication platform, but with a better you can say better protection or privacy policy, right? And just like, you know, there are that data cloud which is there, the cloud of data or the data that is present of Indians, that should remain in India only, or it should not be sold. Like in Zoom, there have been certain speculations were there. So following that, India had launched its own apps, and now India is promoting them towards the public level also. And India has joined Iran-Russia Maritime Security Belt 2021, which is a two-day naval exercise. And this naval exercise was also joined by China, and there were Russian vessels also. Lots of Russian vessels have participated in this, and Chinese Navy has also participated in this drill. And we all know India-China relations, that's why the focus has been on China. Then Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched a pilot pay Jal Sarvekshan, and this is under the Jal Jeevan Mission Urban. Now, what is happening? That is the we can say mapping of all the water bodies is going to be done under the Sarvekshan. So this Sarvekshan, just like we have We had a survection for all the land that is going on. Similarly, for water bodies, we are conducting a survection. And 10 cities are there which have been identified where this survection has been or is going to be launched. So initially, there are 10 cities. Furthermore, other cities are going to be added. And how wastewater is being reused, what is being done, what are the water bodies, everything is going to be kept a tab on. Then Supreme Court has registered a Suomoto contempt against journalist Rajdeep Sardesai. Dr. Kiran Bedi has been removed as Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry, and in her place, Dr. Tamilsai Soundarajan, who is a governor of Telangana, he has been selected to relieve her, or he is going to take place of Dr. Kiran Bedi as Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry for time being as per the presidential order. Then Amazon India has made an announcement to start manufacturing of electronic products in India, and in that the first is going to be the Fire Stick. Right now, the Amazon Fire Stick is going to be manufactured in India, and soon enough, all the other electronics are going to be manufactured in India, seeing the success of the Fire Stick manufacturing and the profit range that is there. Then 11th Water Petrocoal Congress and World Future Fuel Summit was organized in New Delhi recently, or it has been recently organized. And if we talk about when was it organized, it was organized on 16th of February. So we know the location, that is Delhi, date, that is 16th of February. And the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, that is Dharmendra Pradhan, who was present in the summit for that part. Right? Now, with this, we wind up the segment, and I hope this session has been helpful to all of you. We'll see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye, take care, and have a wonderful day ahead.